Shalom Aleichem. Thank you, Rabbi Yaakov, for the kind invitation once again. It's always a real privilege to be able to learn Torah with all of you. I figured the only thing that could possibly be better than sharing the words of the Tzaddikim would be sharing the words of the Tzaddikim while walking through the streets of Yerushalayim. So today we have the distinct privilege of learning a Torah from the Me'ashi Loach, the Ishbitzer, where the Rebbe, the Tzaddik, explains a teaching from his great Rebbe, Rav Simcha Bunim of Pshischa. Rav Simcha Bunim said that when Yaakov Avinu went into exile, when he spent that time cloistered within the home of Lavan and Besuel, sojourning in a distant, faraway land, those two characters, Lavan and Besuel, whose names on the surface, on the outside, seem to imply a whole world of purity, of light, of whiteness, of that untapped resource, the reservoir of all that is right and good in the world, when in reality, those midos tovos of Lavan and Besuel really belong to the Jewish people. Yaakov Avinu's time in exile was not a time of pain and suffering, was not a time of self-loathing or self-consciousness, but instead was an opportunity to go and redeem those things which had fallen into disrepair. The Maharal explains that really all gullus, every gullus experience, which comes from this lashon of gal, a wave which crashes down onto the sea to reveal that which is hidden beneath the sands of time, comes to redeem and to reveal the geula, the aleph, which is buried within that gimel and lamed, which has somehow been lost in our wanderings, in our goings, in our comings. So Yaakov Avinu is there in the house of Lavan and Besuel, and he's trying to redeem those missing pieces from the Jewish people. It wasn't that long ago that we were reading Parsha Shlach, and we learned of the avoda that the meraglim were supposed to not be meraglim, but they were supposed to go. Their original instruction was lasur es haaretz, to go to see the good of the land. Dafka, if you look at the Targum explains on the word lasur es haaretz, it says v'ya'alulun es haaretz. Alun comes from the lashon of elul, which means to go and to see the good things. Lasur means to go and to seek out all of those positive points. And so Yaakov Avinu, when he goes into the house of Lavan, when he goes into the house of Besuel, and he's trying to redeem those lost sparks, he recognizes that this is a time of Elul. This is a time of seeking out Lasur to go find those pieces of himself, of his nation, that somehow fell into disrepair, that somehow fell into the wrong hands. And so this is the job of every single Jew during the month of Elul, to go and to collect the sparks that fell into disrepair, that fell into the wrong hands, that fell to the Lavan and the Besuels of the world, that are still there in all of their whiteness, in all of their purity, in all of their untapped holiness, and to take back what really belongs to us. Elul is not supposed to be a time of heaviness, it's not supposed to be a time of yayush, of despair, of looking at ourselves in a small way, but rather to collect all of those things that fell into Golos and to reveal the Alufu Shel Olam in between them.